whoa. Hey, you! Can you hear me? You can? That must mean you're the hero of legend! Yay, we're the hero of legend! Only the great hero of legend can hear my voice. Yeah, everyone else, nothing. Wow, that's amazing. That might also show why Franklin and Goombella are not reacting to this. See, long ago an evil spirit sent a curse on me, locking me in this box. I was bummed. You were cursed, and all you could do was just be bummed about it. Wow, alright. I've been here ever since, waiting a long, long time for the hero to come by. So, yeah, anyway, big guy, what brings a hero like you to a place like this? Well, we're just looking for the thousand-year door. Hey, Mario, a word with you? I'm confident we can trust this box. Oh, frankly, can hear him. Does that mean he's the hero of legend, too? It may be best not to mention that we're looking for the crystal stars. Well, drat. You done goofed. You had one job, frankly! I said out loud, what's wrong with me? Oh, yeah? Searching for the crystal stars, are you now? So you really are a hero. Well, you're definitely going to need my help if you hope to get those back, boys. So, first you should look for the key to this box, and use it to let me out. Definitely. By the way, the key looks like this. Okay, that looks like a key. Alright. Well, what do you think we ought to do, Mario? Let's help him out! You know, well, I know my vote goes to you finding that key. I'm sure it's around here somewhere. Come on, being stuck in the box is no picnic. I'm counting on you, oh great legendary hero. Well, with us being heroes and all, let's go ahead and look for this here key. You know, I mean, let's help him out. Let's help him out. I screwed that up. I totally, utterly screwed that up. So let's go ahead and jump back up here. And grab that key! Yeah, black key, straight black key, but what could it be for? I assume it's to open up that box! All those sounds he made. Alright! Let's go ahead. Whoa, you brought the key! Yes! Oh man, I owe you big! Let's go ahead and use it. Yes! Thank nothing! What? Have we been duped? Fools! Ah, snap, we've been duped. Oh, this is not good! That face! Oh boy, did you fall for it? I burned you! What, you think I was going to help you? Instead, I'm going to spread a little of the suffering I've endured in that stupid box. Yeah, sorry, but those are the breaks. I'm going to cast an evil, terrible curse upon you. Buggly Wuggly Woo, you're cursed! I did not know curses, you know, come in the Buggly Wuggly Woo sense, but alright. Wee, enjoy that curse, sucker! You got what you deserved. You want to hear all about the sweet curse I just dropped? Then listen well. Now on, if you press Y in certain areas, you'll turn into a paper airplane! Oh dear God, no. Wee-hee! Trembling yet? Suffer the rest of your days under my terrible curse. Wee-hee-hee! Oh, I can't help but chortle! You're doomed! This curse is pretty rough, I owe it to you to explain it! Cannot read today! Ready? If you stand on the airplane panel like this, the floor will start to glow. Yeah, okay, you're on the panel. Now try pressing Y, and then bam, you're a paper airplane. Oh my God, this is just horrible! Worst part of this curse is that you must tilt left and right to control yourself. I guess if you got good at it, you might fly a long way. But that's the only good thing! So be honest, isn't this curse just about the worst thing that's ever happened to you? Yes, I get it. It's terrible. Wee-hee-hee, if you press B, you might return to normal. Maybe. Oh, we did! Farewell, you foolish fool. Wee-hee-hee! Welp, we're cursed. We're cursed. So, wow, just wow. What was that guy's beef? Are you black? Alright, whatever. But yeah! We're doomed to a life of cursehood. That can only be shown off in certain areas, and that's not permanent or damaging whatsoever. Yay for curses! Wait, oh, why, that's right. I fly like paper, get high like planes. Alright. A little MIA for you there. Is that the thousand year door? Yeah, it is. It is. Alright. Oh, Mario, Goombella, look at that! So So I guess nobody ever saw this because they couldn't fly like paper and get high like planes. Alright, it's a thousand-year door! It's woken up in the legends! I can't believe it's real! So the legends are all true. There it is, big as life. Come, let's move closer. Will do. Slowly. And no, we're on a time limit here. First, let me just look for star coins. There is a save, blah. Why did I say star coins? I'm just confusing all of my Mario lore into like just one little hodgepodge of something. Alright. Isn't there a star piece in here? Alright, screw you. What am I saying screw you to? The room? Alright, whatever. Hey, what's the deal with this weird pedestal, huh? What could it be, you think? Oh, I gotta move there, okay. Oh, something magical is happening! Professor, what's going on? Magic is going on, Goombella. Magic! I like how the 2D world just went 3D right there, but okay. Seriously, I mean, Paper Mario is like strictly 2D. Unless it's Super Paper Mario. Whatever. I love that screen effect for some reason. I don't know why. Location of a crystal star has been recorded on your magical map! Hey, Mario has learned a special move! Ooh, you can now use Sweet Treat. Each time you get a crystal star, you'll learn a new special move. Yeah, we can use Sweet Treat! Professor, the map! And what was with all those crazy lights? It appears that information related to the location of the crystal stars appeared. And that shining light, it looked as if a mysterious power was given to Mario. Well, one way or another, we should return to my place and study the map closely. Will do.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah indeed, Mario. Oh yeah in frickin' deed. Aha, I see. You understand it, Professor? My dear, of course I do. Firstly, about that light we saw shining on Mario. By my reckoning, Mario can now perform what is known as a special move. A special move? I like how they're just, like, giving this the utmost importance, you know, just talking about it. Like, it's part of the story, but whatever. Yes, stuff like this is better explained by example rather than words. Would you like to try it out? Might as well, for the purposes of this series. Excellent, in that case, we'll go outside since this place is a little cramped. Yay, we got fans! Some toads and a hammer, bro! Alright! First, take a close look at your star power gauge. Right there. Star power gauge. Oh, yeah. You'll see that your gauge is one power dot. Obviously, that's a single unit of power. So you're sitting on a single dot of star power. With me so far? Yes. If you have star power available, you can use a special move. Here, I use a sweet treat now. Special move that will replenish your HP and FP. Well, I haven't lost any FP because I don't have any, you know, special attacks yet. Or skills, or whatever they're called in this game. I forget! Why do those toes keep looking back here? They're breaking the fourth wall! Alright, but anyway, sweet treat. Really tilt left to shoot hearts and flowers. Wait, no, shoot hearts and flowers. You're shooting the stars at the hearts and flowers, okay? Just do this wildly. Need to avoid the poison mushrooms. That's not a good thing. I just like spamming it, because you end up, like, getting a profit anyway, even if you do hit some mushrooms. Alright, there we go. We got full HP! Since you used one power dot, the star power gauge is now empty. Take a look. Oh my god. It's empty. Even if the gauge empties out, though, you can still charge it up again. That's why the audience watching your battles is so very important. Yep, their cheers refills your star gauge. You can't get the audience excited. Oh, if you can get the audience excited, rather, you'll build up more star power. Let me show you what I mean. Mario Goombella, try to attack me, please. Will do. Yep. Your cheers fills your gauge. Nice. See that? You drilled your audience, so they filled up some of your gauge. Alright. And, like, if you hit a stylish move, too, that makes them cheer even harder. It fills more of your gauge. And it brings more fans. Nice. Keep building up that star power. Also, the more exciting your battles are, the more people will come and watch you fight. As you can see, that's reflected in the number of members in this audience. Yep, we have 16. Alright. I am not good with her style of moves. Mario, this is your chance to hit it big. Yes, that little bonus mini-game thing right there. Nail the action command when you have two matching icons and icon wheels appear. Give it a try. Let's see. Please let me get the Shine Sprite! Yes! Or I think it automatically does that. You get bingo! And all of your things refill, and you get a max audience. Maximum capacity. Yep. Fantastic, you match three icons. When you match those icons, the crowd goes nuts and people swarm the theater. Plus, depending on the icons to match up, your HP, FP, or star power will fill up. And Shine Sprite does it all. But if you get three poison mushrooms, something terrible will happen, so be careful. Seriously, do not line up the poison mushrooms. Still, with me, the more people in your audience, the more star power you can get. You can also use the appeal command to get star power. I hope you memorized all this. Yeah, appeal is just like playing to the audience. Great Goomba's Ghost, Mario! Look at your audience! What? That hammer, bro! What? No! No, you were cheering for me, man! Why you gotta throw that hammer? Does that guy have a hammer? He does! The bummy means to toss it at you. If the audience members hit you with anything, you'll take damage. Obviously. Yeah, obviously. You have to press X to stop them before they hit you. Get out of my theater! You are not allowed here, boy! Only toads. That's right, sweet justice. You can press X to protect yourself from the objects the audience throws at you. Of course, fans of yours might toss good stuff, like coins. Don't attack them. Yeah, you sometimes get a little trigger happy, because I, many a time, have missed out on health that was well needed because of that. Well, that's all I've got. Here is tonight's scintillating lecture on special moves. Let's go back inside. Bye, everybody! Hope you have fun watching that battle! Alright, let's have a look at that magical map and see what we can learn about the... Wow, astounding! This map has radar-like functions. It now shows the location of the crystal star. Looks like the first crystal star will be found in a place called the Petal Meadows. Petal Meadows? I'm stressing the T because if I don't, it sounds like pedal. Like on a bike. Yes, the area is a vast meadow that lies far to the east of Roadport. To tell you the truth, I've always thought that place was a tad suspicious. The name Petal Meadows did come up from time to time in my research. Okay, fine, so we'll go there. Does anybody know how to get there or what? I'm fairly certain that somewhere beneath the city is a pipe to Petal Meadows. You could find that. You'll find... Find that, you get there instantly! Pipe travels efficient! You gotta be efficient, people! Nobody likes inefficiency! Say, by the way, Mario, I'm curious. Where did you get this map anyway? Princess Peach! Princess Peach? Really? Her Highness sent this to you, Mario? It's Princess Peach. This wouldn't be her, would it? Why, yes indeed it would! So it is her! Your princess came to see me the other day. She wanted to learn about the treasure. I told her about the crystal stars and my suspicions about Petal Meadows. It doesn't seem likely, but perhaps she tried to go to Petal Meadows on her own. Alright. You know, Professor, there's another suspicious group asking about the same thing. But I can't imagine Princess Peach getting involved with them. Alright, it's settled. Off to Petal Meadows you two go. If Princess Peach indeed went there, your first priority must be to catch up to her. Collecting the crystal stars is a means to an end, and that end is Princess Peach. There's a double entendre in that. Aren't you coming, Professor? No, I'll stay in town and ask around about Princess Peach and that suspicious gang. Besides, I doubt a shriveled old Goomba like me could handle the trials of the road. Of course, if anything happens and you need some advice, come see me, okay? You got it, Professor. Well, Mario, we're off! Like, see, why talk to Merlovely, you know, why pay for a tip from Merlovely when you just talk to him for free? Alright, whatever. Anyway, off we go! Wait just a moment! Ooh, a badge! You got Power Smash. Mario, it's scary out there! Take this with you. dangerous to go alone. Take this. It's got a badge, and it is incredibly helpful. You see, depending on the badges you have equipped, you'll get much more powerful. What's important is knowing what effects will be when you first equip a badge. Like to practice equipping? No, because this one I got. Are you absolutely sure? Alright, fine if you insist! Okay, first press start to access your menu screen. Alright. Gotta select badges. That's the party menu right there. That's your gear menu right there. Your badges. Press, badge. Press A. You equip it! Use 1 BP for this one. Yeah, BP, your badge points. You know, like, they give you badge points so that you don't exploit the system and make the game super easy. So, yeah! You also remove it. Remove a badge like that, yeah, okay. By the way, you need flower points to use the Power Smash move. In battle, you should watch not only your HP, but FP too. Did you get all that? Here's something you find that Pipe Meadows. So, yeah, let's go ahead and re-equip it. Why not? It's helpful. Huh. Well, now that I have that, I could fight him. Nah, I ain't about to mess with Gus right now. I ain't about to mess with Gus. Because I'll wait till I do my HP up a bit. Alright. So now, to find that pipe. So yeah, we just do this, you know, because we couldn't access this before. Oh, enemy! Ah, crap! Oh, I thought I landed on him. Alright. Gotta kill the enemies first. Must commit mass genocide. I only have a Goomba fan now? What happened? Alright, but anyway, we're gonna show off Power Smash. It's done the same way, but it does more damage. Alright. Now let us do this. Yeah. I am not that good at flying. Alright. That's a blooper tentacle! Freaking hate bloopers! Ouch, that hurt! Oh, they have the little subtitles right there. That's nice. That is one big blooper. And he is mad! Who just up and whacked someone's tootsies like that? Somebody with some serious moxie, that's who! Why'd I give him that voice? I don't know. Would you look at that? It's some saucy mustache guy! Oh, we're saucy! He's in a world of hurt. Alright, let's go ahead and take care of this baddie. I'll give him a taste of the old tentacle trample! Hey Mario, you remember what Professor Frankly told us, right? You can press X to, Y to change our attack order. Tree drops, you can press Y to put me in front. But we cannot flee! Alright, so let's go ahead and tattle! Let's do it with style! That's a blooper and a really super humongous one too. Ew, it's all slimy. I like that sketch in the book of them. That's nice. I just totally can't stand slimy, nasty, icky things. GRLSS, gross! Extreme is 12, attack is 1, and defense is 0. And attacks with tentacles and 8. Just like a squid. So you damage both its tentacles, it'll fall down, and then it's attack time. By the way, the tentacles each have 3 HP. Now relax and house that slimy, nasty blooper. Agreed! Bloopers are horrible, and I hate them, and crap! Crap, I'm not good at timing this. Me? Crap. Alright. There we go. Alright. Come on, Mario! There we go. Alright. And let us make quick work of him. Well, as quick as possible. Now, how could I prepare for that? This shoddy stage! We need a better one, man! You got lights falling down on people? That's messed up, yo. Alright, only, you know, one more turn and we got this. One more turn. Just stay on the ground, thank you, alright. Yes! Attack his front tentacle to do damage to his whole body. Physics at work! I like how he falls over. I like so many things about this game, just the small little touches. Oh, no subtitles for that one. But I assume it was a cry of pain and suffering. Platforming! Bye, Goombella! Oh. Goombella! Jump, damn it. Oh my god. Alright.